Belinda Audiobooks presents this unabridged recording of Aussie Bites, Rattler's Place by Patricia Wrightson, and read by Stig Weems. Be sure to check us out on the web at www.belinda.com. Rattler's Place. When Guy moves to his new house, things are not quite right. There's no bike, no skateboard, and worst of all, there's no Digby the dog. But then there's Rattler, and suddenly things are not so bad after all. Rattler's Place by Patricia Wrightson. Chapter 1. It was an old house, but the Dents had just bought it, so it was new for them. A long way from their old home. The town was new for them too. Guy thought he would like living here when school started. There would be people then and things to do. Now it was lonely. There was no one next door because the house was a little way out of town. Dad was away all day looking for a shop to buy. Mum was doing stuff on the computer and fixing the house. Katie was too little for Guy's games. He helped Mum a bit with the house. The beds and the tables and the chairs were in the right places, but they still didn't look right. Some pretty important things hadn't even come yet. Guy's skateboard and football, Katie's doll and its stuff, and a lot of her old rag animals. The building sets and train set and bikes, all their special things, as well as Digby, their dog. In the house, a lot of cupboards and shelves were still empty, because there were boxes still full. You opened up a box and found towels or sheets or books. Then you had to put them away in the new place. Guy and Mum were doing that now. Mum had blankets in her box and Guy had a lot of old clean dusters.
Sort them into small and big ones, will you, Guy?
Guy started two piles.
Will Digby be all right? He asked. When will he get here?
Mum had answered these questions pretty often, but she knew Guy was worried, so she answered them again.
He's safe in the dog's home till that flood goes down. He'll come with your bikes and things. We don't know when, but it won't be long.
He'll like it here, said Guy. That big backyard going down the hill and the bush outside the fence.
And us being here, said Mum,
and they smiled. Katie came in. She was nursing a brick. She had found it in the garage and carried it all the way up the back stairs.
Oh, Katie, cried Mum, a dirty old brick.
Katie looked surprised.
It's not dirty. It's Ellie. Will you dress her, Mum?
But she's so heavy, Kate. If she falls on your foot, she might break your toe.
Katie screwed up her eyes, trying to find the right words.
Babies have to be heavy, she said at last.
Mum sighed.
They have to be bathed too. I'll give you a dish of water and some soap, and Guy will give you that old towel he's found. And is this a good frock for Ellie?
She took out of Guy's box an old white curtain with lace on it, and Katie reached for it.
Come on then, said Mum. I think there's some baby powder you can use.
They went away to the bathroom. Guy kept on sorting the dusters till Mum came back.
I'll buy her a doll in a day or so, Mum fretted. If only I can get to the shops.
It's all right, said Guy. She likes the brick.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.